All right, this is all we've got left, naming covalent compounds. And it is so much easier than naming ionic compounds. You are gonna love this, okay? Because here's the thing, when we did ionic compounds, they had to come together to cancel the number of the charge, right? So if I put Mg2+ together with Cl minus, then it, like, there was only one possibility. I have to call it MgCl2, right? Had to be that. Well, covalent compounds, because they bond by sharing electrons, and there's lots of different ways to share electrons. Now there's a crazy mixture, right? So I could put one N with one O, and that's a valid compound. Your brain makes that as a neurotransmitter. I could put one N with two O's, make NO2. I can then make one N with, two N's with one O. That's another valid compound. I can make N2O4. Like, all of these are real compounds. So there's no way to say, yes, I'm bonding nitrogen with oxygen. What's the structure? Like I could do with magnesium and chlorine. So the nomenclature rules that we use are completely different for covalent compounds. And mostly what they do is they just tell you how many of each atom you have. We're going to use Greek prefixes. So you're going to say, let's see, here's your table of Greek prefixes. It's in your lecture notes. Some of these might be familiar, like dec for 10 and non for 9 and oct for 8 and hept for 7 and hex for 6 and pent for 5. Tri for 3, like a triangle. Tetra for 4, like a tetrahedral. Di for 2, mono for 1. Okay, so what you do to name ionic compounds, sorry, not ionic, to name covalent compounds, and here we're going to name simple binary, that is with just two different types of atoms, like nitrogen and oxygen atoms. To name binary covalent compounds, we're going to name the first element with a Greek prefix to indicate how many there are. Not mono. If there's just one, we don't have to say mono. Then we are going to name the second element with the Greek prefix to indicate how many of that atom there is. That's what we do. Whoa. And IDE suffix. Okay, sorry, missed that bit. So that's it. Let's show you what I mean. So for these ones that I did here, NO, the first one is nitrogen. The first element is nitrogen. There's one of them, so it would be mononitrogen, but I don't say mono because it was the first one listed. So I just call it nitrogen. Nitrogen and then space. And now I'm going to name that second element, oxygen, with an IDE suffix, so it's oxide, and there's just one of them, so I use that Greek prefix, monoxide. And I do, it's not monooxide. If there's two vowels, I usually drop one of them. So it's just easier to say nitrogen monoxide. What about this one up here? What do you think? NO2. Nitrogen, good. There's just one of them, so I don't have to say mononitrogen because it's the first atom listed. And then because there's two oxygens, I'm going to call it diox with the IDE suffix because it's the second one that was listed, nitrogen dioxide. Good. What about this one, N2O? Dinitrogen. And now I do need the mono again, right? Because there's just one oxygen there and it's the second atom listed. So monoxide, not monoxide. I drop one of the O's. Dinitrogen monoxide. What about this one right here? N2O4. Dinitrogen tetroxide. Isn't that nice? Isn't this so much easier than ionic compounds? Like, dang, I wish ionic compounds were this easy to name. So much simpler. Just tell me how many there are of each of those atoms. It makes my life easier. Okay. So I can tell you, I feel like the trickier thing is when it comes to nomenclature. Here you've got, you know, provide names for each of the compounds or formulas for each of these. The trickier thing is that on the exam, it's not going to be as clear. I'm not going to say name this covalent compound, and I'm not going to say name this ionic compound. I'm just going to say name this compound, and you have to determine, is this ionic or covalent? Like, which rules do I need to follow? And then follow those rules. And if it's covalent, then hopefully it's pretty simple here. Does that make sense? That is it. That's it for lecture today. Anyways, I'll let you go. Have a good weekend.